Hello everyone, so I welcome you all on this new lecture on approximate analytical method. So in this lecture we'll solve one problem based on this method. So in previous lecture we have seen the derivation part of approximate analytical method. So we have seen how we can calculate the velocity of slider, acceleration of slider, angular velocity of connecting rod, angular acceleration of connecting rod. So in this lecture we'll solve a simple problem based on this method. So first of all, you just note down the problem. So just here is the problem. Okay, so now just read the problem carefully, because many things are given in the problem. So based on the problem, based on the statement of the problem, first of all you have to draw your diagram. And if you read the problem carefully, so first of all I write down the given data for the problem. If you read the problem, they have given the stroke length of slider, and the stroke length of slider will be represented by S. That value is 200 mm given to you. Okay, so with the help of stroke length, what we can find out? So with the help of stroke length, we can find out the radius of crank, because I know the stroke is nothing but total movement of piston, and total movement of piston will be governed by the rotation of crank. So I know the stroke is nothing but twice of radius of crank. So if we solve this one, we'll get radius of crank as 100. So this is the first thing given to you. Next, they have given obligatory ratio. So we represent the obligatory ratio by N, and obligatory ratio is given as 4, and I know obligatory ratio is nothing but L by R ratio. So if you solve this equation, you will get the value of L as 400 mm, because the value of R was already 100 we have. Okay, next is, they have given one more thing, that is the RPM. Because the crank is rotating in clockwise direction with 1500 RPM. So we know the use of RPM. Based on RPM, we can find out the angular velocity of crank. So if we'll do this one, so omega of crank will be 2 pi n by 60, and the value of this one is coming as 157.08 radian per second. Okay, listen, we need to put the value of N as 1500 and solve the equation. You get omega as 157.08 radians per second. So these are the given data with you. Okay, now one most important thing is given to you, that they have given the value of displacement, that is represented by xp. Okay, and that displacement is given as 50 mm. So if you read the problem carefully, the displacement of 50 mm is given with reference to certain point. Okay, so in the problem they have mentioned that displacement xp is equals to 50 mm from BDC. That is the most important part of the problem. From BDC, 15 mm they have given. BDC and TDC is what? Bottom dead center and top dead center. Means what? All the data is here that is related to vertical engine, because the word BDC is given to you. Okay, so based on all the given data, we will draw first of all mechanism of slider crank mechanism. So let's say first of all your slider is somewhere here. Okay, now you have to draw your crank position. So from this point I draw my crank position. But let's suppose this is nothing but the rotation of your crank. The crank, with the crank radius, it is rotating somewhat like this. Okay, so this is nothing but the rotation of crank. So this will be, this part will be called as TDC, and this lowermost is called as BDC. Okay, now your crank is rotating in clockwise direction, that they have mentioned, that 150 rpm in clockwise direction. So if the crank rotation is started from this point and it is rotating like this, okay, and the movement, the displacement of piston of 50 mm is given from BD. See, means what? When this part, when the crank is somewhere here, 50 mm, the, when it is departed certain part from, certain angle from BDC, then the movement is given to you. So at this particular position, your movement of crank is given to you. Okay, so this is nothing but the angle from BDC you are making. We don't know that angle. So when the piston is at this point, your piston was, when the crank was on this point, the piston was on BDC. Now it is moving a certain degree from BDC, and now this certain degree, because this certain degree, the piston is moving from BDC to this end point, and this point is given as 50 mm. So this is nothing but your BDC. When the BDC is here, when the crank is here, this piston will be somewhere here. Okay, so if piston is moving from here to here, that displacement is given as 50 mm. Okay, so let's name all the points based on the previous derivation. So this point was O, this point is nothing but my C point, this point was P. Now for this particular configuration, you are supposed to find out the angular velocity, angular acceleration of connecting rod, acceleration and velocity of piston. Okay, clear with anyone? So now the value of xp is given to you. So we'll solve, we'll start the problem solving from xp only. And I know the value of xp is nothing but r into 1 plus n minus cos theta minus root over of n square minus sin square theta. That expression we have already derived in the previous lecture. If you have not seen the previous lecture, so go on, go and see the first previous lecture. First of all, the link of previous lecture is in the description box. Okay, so you can see the previous lecture, then this lecture will be very clear to you. Okay, so let's put down the value. So xp value is given as 0.05. It's mm is given to you, so I'll convert this mm into meter. R value is given as 0 point, the value is R is 100 mm, so it's 0.1 mm. So 1 plus n is given as 4 minus cos theta is unknown to you, that you are supposed to find, minus n square is again 4, so that is 16 minus sin square theta. Okay, so here I have expression. So in this expression, only one value of is unknown, that is called as theta. So you can solve this equation and find out the value of theta. So let's solve a bit, and you can also solve it. You can solve it by any method. You can directly put this entire equation in calculator and you will get the value of theta. Or you can solve it like this also. So let's do the cross multiplication and subtract from here. Okay. So if we substitute it, so let's take this part on the right side and this part will be on the left side only. So this 16 root over of 16 minus sin square theta will be here. Okay, and on this side you will have a, so 5 minus 0.05 divided by 0.1 minus cos theta. So this will be the expression on the right side. So this will be divided, 0.1 will be divided in 0.5, and this will be the expression. So if you solve this one, you will get the value of theta as, so I have that value actually, you are getting the value as 54.31 degrees. Okay. So once you solve this one, you will get the value of theta. So this is still nothing but this value of theta you have, 54.31. Okay, so this is the value of theta we have. Okay, and if the value of theta is coming as in positive, then we can assume the theta value is in the clockwise direction. If the value will come in negative, then we will assume theta is on the anticlockwise direction, but your motion is given in the clockwise direction, so that's why I have written, I have directly drawn the diagram, and I know I was going, the value is going to be 54.7%. Okay, now the important thing is, whatever the derivation we have done for velocity analysis, for acceleration analysis, in all the derivations, the values of theta we have taken from this starting point only, from this TDC point only. And we have derived for horizontal engine that we have derived from horizontal engine, so that value we have taken from TDC only. So if the values are taken from TDC only, and now we have the value that is 54.31, that value is from BDC. So you have to find out the another value of theta, and that theta is nothing but 180 plus 54.31, and that 180 plus 54.31 is the value given from TDC, and with this value I am going to put in all the calculation of velocity and acceleration. Okay, so this will be coming as 234.31 degrees. So this is the final value of theta we have. Okay, so now we have the value of theta, that angle rotation by crank. So now we can find out the velocity of piston and acceleration of piston. So let's do this one. So first of all, we will find out the velocity of piston. So for finding the velocity of piston, the value for velocity of piston will be omega r into sin theta plus sin twice theta upon twice. So this is the value, this is the derivation, this is the expression we have already derived in the previous picture. So let's put down the value. So value of omega was equals to 157 something. So it's 157.08. R is 0.1. So R value I am taking in meter. So value of velocity will be in meter per second. Okay. Now you have to put the value of sine theta. So let's put the value here. So we will have 147.08 multiplied by 0.1 and sine theta. So it's sine of theta. Now what should be the value of theta? Whether it is 54 or 234? So I have already discussed in this problem also. So value of theta we have taken while deriving the problems from TDC point, from initial point only. So here also you have to take the value from initial point. And based on the sine of VP, we can decide whether it is going upward direction or whether it is going in the downward direction. So I will put the theta as 234.31 degrees here, plus sine of 2 multiplied by 234.31 degrees divided by 2n. 2 into n is what? Obviously the ratio that is equals to. So if we solve the entire equation, just multiplying calculator, the value we get is minus 10.8988 meter per second. So this is the value of velocity we are going to have. Minus 10 point. What do you mean by this minus sign now? So in previous lecture, we have seen the derivation Vp value was this one, and that value will be positive if the piston is moving from TDC to BDC, that is in the downward velocity. Now the velocity is moving from, piston is moving from BDC to TDC again, means what? This value is coming as negative. Means what? This negative sign indicates that your piston is moving from BDC to TDC. That is the most important part. Your piston is moving from lower to higher side. Chale. Second one, we need to find out the acceleration of the piston. So acceleration of the piston, the formula for acceleration of the piston is omega square r, instead of sin theta the value will be cos theta plus cos of 2 theta, instead of Poisson there is an n only. So here I am using this equation. This equation was valid for uniform velocity of crank, because the alpha, that is angular velocity of crank, is not given. So that's why we have to use the formula for uniform velocity of crank. If the value of alpha was also given to you, then I have to use non-uniform velocity of crank equation. That is alpha into r into something more. Okay. So now, if this is the value, so I will put the value again. So it's 157.08 square multiplied by r is 0.1 and cos theta. So it's cos of 234 again, 0.31 plus cos of 2 multiplied by 234.31 divided by n is 4. So if you solve this equation, you will get the acceleration of piston as minus 1636.4 meter per second. And what do you mean by negative sign here again? Again, the piston is moving from BDC to TDC in the same direction. Okay, so if the piston is moving from BDC to DC, that we can see from here also, because the displacement is given from BDC on. So now we need to calculate two more things, that is called as acceleration of the piston as well as angular acceleration of connecting rod and angular velocity of connecting rod. So first of all, let's calculate the angular velocity of connecting rod. Third one is called as angular velocity of connecting rod, that is omega of PC. So the formula for omega PC is nothing but omega into cos theta upon. So that is the formula we have derived. So omega value was equals to 157.08 multiplied by cos of theta. Cos of theta was coming as 234.34 and this n was equals to. Okay, now the value of omega PC is coming as minus 23.397 is what? It's radian per second. So if this is the value you have, what do you mean by this minus sign now? So your crank was moving in clockwise direction. What this minus sign indicates? Because this minus sign, you can comment that your connecting rod rotation is in the opposite to the direction of crank. Minus sign can indicate karega? It's opposite to the direction of crank. Okay, so connecting rod direction is, if crank is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, the connecting rod is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, now the fourth one, last one, alpha of PC, angular acceleration of connecting rod. So that value will be minus of omega square sine theta upon, and again I am using this for uniform angular velocity of crank. Okay, so if the value of alpha was given, only you have to add this non-uniform angular velocity part. Sorry, angular acceleration part. Sorry. So minus of 157.08 square multiplied by sine of 234.34 n was equals to, and the value is coming as 5009.99. So this is nothing but the value of alpha of PC, and that value is also in radians per second square. So this is the value of angular acceleration of connecting rod. So in this way we can solve the problem. So this problem is very easy. Only you have to remember the formula for all angular velocity and angular acceleration and acceleration. So problem is not easy. Only a little bit trick is given on this portion when the displacement is given from the BDC. So if we'll put the values of theta as 54.31, then this that value will be wrong in the sense of direction. Okay, so if you put this value as 34 in angle, if you put this 54.31, then you will get the velocity as positive one, so that will not justify your current configuration diagram. Okay, so okay, thank you.